Okay, let's start today's class. Today we are going to discuss a new topic. The topic is in child psychiatry, conduct disorder. So conduct disorder is a type of behavioral problems. So particularly when we are in the childhood age, we commit lot of naughty things. Sometimes that will be good. Sometimes that will be hurting others. So if you continuously doing something which is hurting others, that becomes a conduct problem. So in the schools, when you are completing the plus two, when you are coming to join colleges, what they are giving? They are giving your transfer certificate and they are also giving your conduct certificate. The conduct certificate tells that how you have behaved with the teachers and in the school, how was your behavior. So if you not behaved properly, if you have a lot of legal issues while studying in the school, so your conduct certificate, the school principal will write poor conduct. So who will get poor conduct? Those who have some problems. Kya kya problems basically, like during the school times, they are bunking the school and they are going outside every day. And during the school time, they are using some kind of substances or they are using some kind of involving in activities like stealing the properties, or they are involving in activities like drinking, or sometimes they are involving in sexual activities, violent activities. So such problems which is affecting the academic performance of the student as well as affecting other students' performance behavior, such problems are called as conduct disorders. So definition says very clearly, conduct disorders are persistent and significant pattern of conduct. So conduct is nothing but your behavior. So it is a persistent, continuously present and significant pattern. Significant pattern means which is not present in all the people, which is present only in some type of students, in which the basic rights of others are often violated. So you are doing some activity that is not going to check the privacy of one person. For example, you do some activity in which the other's rights are violated, the privacy of other person is violated. Such things are called as conduct disorders. Okay, for example, if the school student or a college student who is particularly 18 years of age or below 18 years of age involved in any activity which is violating the rules and regulation of the society, that particular problem, if it is present for a long period of time and it is significantly seen in that particular student, that is called as conduct disorder. Conduct disorder having different characteristics. Now let's see the characteristics of conduct disorder. First one is frequent lying. So every time they used to tell jhoot, hamesha jhoot batayenge. Teachers ke saath jhoot bolte hain, parents ke saath jhoot bolte hain. Particularly the problem is diagnosed from the school teachers only. In the house, how you behave, that is not a matter. How the particular student behave in the school, with the friends, with the teachers, that is matter. Frequent lying. Next one is stealing and doing robbery. That is, you are doing some kind of chori activities. You are stealing the other student's property. You are stealing the school properties. That is stealing and robbery. Running away from the home and school. That is called juvenile delinquency. Juvenile delinquency. So, kya hota hai? Particularly, you are saying to your parents that you are going to school. But you are not going to school. You go to school and from the school you are escaping, and either you are going to the park, movie, or you are going to beach, or you are going to some other places. That is called as running away from home and school. The psychiatric term is called juvenile delinquency. Juvenile means child, bachpan period. Okay. Next one is involving in any activities like physical violence, fighting with other students, making group, and doing some kind of vandalism behavior. Vandalism behavior matlab damaging the property, public properties, like damaging the school properties, like bench, desk, school classrooms mein koi saman hai, you are damaging that particular samans, like cupboard, light, fan, or if there is a school van, you are breaking the glasses, you are making the puncture to the seat, tires, such kind of behavior, vandalism property. And rape, particularly childhood period may, there will be excess amount of sexual hormones that may lead to rape kind of behavior. But this is very less common in India, but nowadays it is growing faster because of this alcohol. When the young age, when we have eagerness to take alcohol, when we take alcohol, our mind is also changed. As a result of that, we are involved in the rape kind of children's will, who is having conduct disorder, will involve in rape activities. And sometimes fire setting aapko pata hai, in 2016 when there was a problem in Jat Arakshan in Rohtak in Haryana, what they did, they keep fire for public transport, they keep fire for the police vehicle. So like that, the children keep fire in other properties, like they will keep the fire to the house, or they will keep fire to the vehicles. Sometimes they keep fire with the bike of other students. If they don't like any teacher, if the teacher is having some vehicle, they will blaze it with fire. Okay, that is fire setting. That is commonly called as pyromania. That is called as pyromania. Assault, you know very well, beating others, fighting with others, physical assault as well as verbal assault, two types hota hai. And the last one, you know that use of weapons. In America and all, the students are having guns and they are going to the classroom with the gun and they are shooting. So in America it is more common, the shootouts are more common. Nowadays in India also, the school children are keeping gun. The parents, if they are having the gun, they are bringing it to the classroom and they are threatening the other students. Sometimes what they are doing, they are keeping talwar, they are keeping chaku, these things they are keeping, and they are involving in the weapon, using the weapon for threatening others in the bachpan period. And next one is cruelty towards other people, particularly bachpan period mein, like small children, they go and kisi ko haath pakad ke they will kaatna, you know na, they will bite the hands. If they are if two girls are fighting each other, how they will fight? They will pull the hair off each other girl and they will fight each other. How boys will fight, particularly boys will fight, like they catch one person hand and they will bite the hand of that person. Sometimes how they will fighting with other, with animal, like one kind of nowadays very common doing TikTok with animal. They are killing the animal for getting more like, for making the video viral in the TikTok. For example, one person in Tamil Nadu, what he did means, he had his domestic cat in his house. He keep the cat in the TikTok video and he put suicide. He hanged the cat and he made the video like he's doing suicide. Now one actor committed suicide, you know now. Who is that actor? I don't know that actor name. The Dhoni movie, one actor committed suicide like that. Some children.
Sushant Singh Rajput.
Rajput Pandey, I think from Bihar. Actually, that is like that. You are making the animal like you are what you are doing. With the animal, you are killing the animal. That is also one kind of conduct disorder problem. Okay, so these things you want to keep in mind. These are the features, characteristic feature of conduct disorder. Now, let us see the what are the etiology, what are the causes of conduct disorder. First one is high risk in the family members. If the parents are taking alcohol, if the father is having some kind of personality disorder like narcissistic personality disorder, definitely that children will have the conduct disorder. That is genetic factor. Next one is biochemical factor. In our body, if the testosterone level is very, very high, I already told you during adolescent period, testosterone level will be high. That's why they are involving in rape activities, sexual assault, aggressive behavior. So that is common among boys. Basically, this conduct disorder is common in the male boys comparing to the girls. Next one is organic factor. That is any damage to the brain, any injury to the brain, and if there is risk of epilepsy, if the children is having epilepsy, seizure, definitely that will lead to conduct disorder. So these are the three etiology of the conduct disorder. Now, other psychosocial factors which is causing the conduct disorder, one is parental rejection. If the parents not loving their children properly, if the parents hate the children, if the parents not taking care of children, the children can have conduct disorder. Harsh discipline. If your parents are coming from military background, if your parents are very strict, if the parents are not leaving the children to live freely, if there is no friendship type of relation between the father, mother and the children, that children will have conduct disorder. That is harsh discipline. Next one is shifting of parental figure. Shifting of parental figure means like you are like the children does not have the real father and mother. For example, in some accident, the real father and mother had died. So during that time, some other family members like Nani, Nana, they will take care of the children. So that is shifting of parental figure. So in that case, the real care of father and mother is not available to the children. So that children will have conduct disorder. Next one is large family size. In our India, particularly in North India, this joint family is more common. In a house, two or three, Tauji, Chachaji, all will be living together. So in the large family, they cannot take care of the children properly. So that children will go for conduct disorder. Next one is parents with ASPD. That is other kind of antisocial personality disorder. ASPD, antisocial personality disorder. So if the parents are criminal, if the father is a alcoholic, if the father have two or three criminal case, if mother is a prostitute, if the mother is having two or three criminal case, that children, their children will get conduct disorder, antisocial personality. Next, diverse parents, like father, mother, they don't live together. They are having judicial separation, divorce. So that children will be affecting. They will get conduct disorder easily. Next one is inadequate communication pattern in the family. So communication pattern, both the father and mother, father is in America, mother is going to job daily. So there is no time for the parents to take care of the children. That children will develop conduct disorder more easily. Now let us see the what are the treatment for conduct disorder. So conduct disorder treatment is you want to keep the children in a corrective institution. Corrective institution matlab like those children bachpan jail, very simple bachpan jail, like if the children create some kind of antisocial behavior, police will arrest them. They will not keep them in the jail in which adults are kept. So bachpan ke liye there is one jail. Even this jail is in present in near that Arpana hospital. Arpana hospital ka thoda aage bachpan jail hai. Next one is behavioral therapy, behavioral education dena hai. So by behavioral education we can change their wrong behaviors. Psychotherapeutic measurements, so any kind of psychotherapy, cognitive therapy, family therapy, individual therapy, supportive therapy, this therapy we can give. As a result of that, the child behavior will be modified. Next one is commonly we give the drugs like anticonvulsant drugs, because I told you if the child is having any organic brain damage and if there is chance of seizure epilepsy to the children, they will get conduct disorder. So such children need a anticonvulsant drugs. Stimulant medication, amphetamine stimulant medication which is needed to treat the children's. Lithium and carbamazepine also needed because the children have excessive amount of energy. So to reduce their energy level, we need lithium and carbamazepine. You know that lithium and carbamazepine are used for treatment of mania. Next one is antipsychotic drugs. Antipsychotic drugs which we are giving for this children to treat any kind of abnormal thinking. Antipsychotic drug will correct the thinking pattern. The cognitive patterns will be corrected. Now the common conduct disorder, first one I told you, juvenile delinquency. It is a disorder in which 16 years of age, that is under 18 year of children who involves in antisocial activity, that is called juvenile delinquency. Particularly like Nirbhaya case, among all the culprit, one culprit alone was a very young age, that is below 18. So such children are called as juvenile delinquent. Any children 18 years below, particularly 16 or less than 16, nowadays government have made the 18 years has been reduced to 16 years from the Nirbhaya case, they corrected the age. So any children in the 16 years or below 16 years committing any criminal activity, they are called as juvenile delinquency. They have the problem. That problem is called juvenile delinquency. The next one is, these are the common causes of juvenile delinquency. One is economical cause. In the family, if they are not having money properly, they involve in stealing activities, they involve in robbing activity. Nowadays, one trend is that, like in Chennai, we have seen many criminal complaints. What will be there means two school children who is coming above 13, above 15 years of age, they go in the bike and they will see if any ladies are walking akele, they will snatch the chain. Also they will, by using the chaku, they threatening others, and what they will do, they will take the cell phone. If you are walking alone, if you are having a cell phone, so be careful. Somebody can come and snatch your cell phone by showing chaku. Next one is psychological causes. We already seen that if the parents are not giving care properly, harsh discipline, if the parents having separate. So these are the problems, that is psychological causes. Social causes, you know, nowadays the crime rate is increasing because of alcoholism. Because nowadays many people are seeing YouTube, and in the YouTube they are searching some kind of legal, how to do criminal activity without catching to the police. So they get idea and they are doing. The social causes very, very important in the causes of juvenile delinquent behavior. Now next thing, the social causes I already told you. Defect in the family separation, like defect in the school. The school discipline is not there. When the school does not bother about the children's behavior, and child living in a crime dominated area. Like if you are living in a good place where all your neighbor, padosi, everyone is educated, everyone is good, then the crime rate is very low. But crime rate is very high in the slum area. The crime rate is very high in the industrial area. So that is the important thing. That is important cause for juvenile delinquent. And war and post-war condition. So if there is any war, you know that during the time of tsunami, 2004, in the tsunami, what happened? Many people died. So the dead bodies have been thrown in the seashore. What happened means many people gone, and they are stealing the chain ring the people are wearing. That from the dead body, they are taking the gold ornaments. So that is the one, any after any natural calamities. So during that time also, juvenile delinquent will happen more. The most chance of happening juvenile delinquent in the war and post-war areas also. Now the next one is psychological causes. Already I told you, personality, emotional insecurity, and mental illness. Economic cause, I told you, poverty, stealing because of no income, they do stealing, and prostitution, that also common. Many children's are kidnapped. Many children's are kidnapped in India every day, and these children's are used in the prostitute business. So that is one of the important factor for the child to convert into a juvenile delinquent. Next one is how to treat that, the reformatory measure. Actually, this is not a disease. This is a behavior. This is a behavior problem. How we can correct for that? First, we want to keep the children in the observation. That is probation. We want to keep the children under our custody. So legal custody, police key control may, you have to keep the children. Next one is reformatory school. You want to send the children to the bachpan period. So probation, parents also can keep the children under their custody, under their vigilance, and send them to reformatory school where they can, the behavior can be corrected, where the school can teach them good behavior. I told you bachpan jail, remand homes, that is remand home. The example is bachpan jail, that is near Arpana Hospital. Near Arpana Hospital, there is Bachpan Jail. Next one is psychological therapy, like play therapy. You can give finger painting and you can give psychodrama. Psychodrama means you want to put a drama to that children. Like we might have, nowadays we are seeing movie, but in olden days, movies nahi hai. Some people will act and they will show like a drama. For example, in our college, you are doing some drama, na? Like in the last fresher, I think you have done a drama in the farewell party. So like that, when we do a drama, the children will learn good thing from the drama, who is acting in the drama. So this is very important. So most of the problem, this juvenile delinquent comes because of inner urge. Inner urge means the urge will be, urge means what? The intention to do something is from the birth. Okay, from the birth it is mostly prasan. Okay, now the next important question in the child psychiatric disorder, this question commonly comes, tic disorder. Tic disorder is very important question, so don't miss the tic disorder. Definitely this question is asked in the exam many times. So what do you mean by tic disorder? That is abnormal involuntary movements which occurs suddenly, repetitively, rapidly, and it is purposeful in nature. That is, the children do any kind of movements repeatedly with the hands, with the legs, or sometimes with the mouth or with the eyes. That is called as tic disorder. So you can see that a person who is suffering from tics maybe rapidly and repeatedly blink. This is misjudgment. Repeatedly, you might have seen Sourav Ganguly. When Ganguly is coming to the bat, when they are showing him close in the camera, he is always blinking the eyes. So that is one kind of tic disorder. You can see that frequently blinking the eyes repeatedly when there is nothing to irritate them. If there is dust in our eyes, we are blinking, that is normal. If there is no dust, simply we are blinking the eyes always, that is called as one kind of tic disorder. This is one example, tic disorder. So tic disorder, basically two types. One is motor tics, another one is verbal tics. Motor tics are characterized by repetitive motor movements. Any kind of movements, repeatedly they will be doing like that, they will be doing like this. So that is motor tics. Verbal tics means like that, every time they do some kind of sounds. Like you can see some people always doing some kind of sounds, so that sounds which will be irritating others. So that is verbal tics. Verbal tics, that is repeatedly giving some kind of sounds, like minor sounds, like always doing sounds like a dog, like you are doing sounds like cat. So sometimes you are doing gargling sound, or sometimes you are doing the sound of snoring. So that is coming under verbal tic. It is characterized by repetitive vocalization. So another type of disorder, in the tic disorder, the common type is Gillis-De-La-Tourette syndrome. So kya hota hai Gillis-De-La-Tourette syndrome? It is a special type of chronic disorder. So Gillis-De-La-Tourette syndrome having three features. One is multiple motor tics and vocal tics. They will be repeatedly doing verbal tics will be repeatedly done, as well as verbal tics ke saath motor tics also present. Multiple verbal and multiple motor tics are commonly present. Next one is the duration. So this problem must be present for 1 year, at least 1 year continuously. If the child is doing that, that is comes under Gillis-De-La-Tourette syndrome. Answer, usually this problem is found in the children 11 years age. After 11 years of age, this problem will not come in the children. 11 years go below, so this problem will come. If the children crosses 11 years, the incidence rate is very less. So this is another important thing. What is the difference between, what are the things comes under simple motor tics? Motor tics two type, simple motor tics and complex motor tics. So simple motor tics, blinking eyes, grimacing, shrugging of shoulder, tongue protrusion. Some people always protrude the tongue outside every time. Complex motor tics includes facial gestures, stamping, jumping, hitting the shelf, squatting, twirling, echokinesis, capropraxia. So all these things are, you can check the dictionary for the meaning of all these things. You know the facial gestures, keeping abnormal facial expression, stamping, jumping, hitting self. Like hitting the self means always doing like that, hitting the self. Squatting, so frequently some people always do squatting position. Squatting means, like, you know, the position how you sit in the toilet. So these things are comes under complex motor tics. Now verbal tics also two type. One is simple vocal tics, another one is complex vocal tics. Simple vocal tics include coughing, barking, throat clearing, sniffing, clicking. Complex vocal tics include echolalia. Echolalia means if some person is speaking, they repeat the words. Echolalia, palilalia, caprolalia. Caprolalia means always speaking the bad words. Caprolalia. And mental caprolalia. Mental caprolalia means imagining the bad words every time. So treatment is you are giving antipsychotic drug haloperidol. So in severe case we can give pimozide or clonidine. We can give. So this is the treatment. So I have completed the child psychiatric disorder. So in the tomorrow we will see community mental health nursing. So if you have any doubt, you can ask now. Now I am taking attendance. I am taking the this video is recording. So please be in the online. I am recording all your name. Who is AR? AR kon hai beta? AR.
Ashish sir. Ashish.
Ashish.
Yes, sir.
Who is that? Okay, Ritika, everyone. I'm noting your name. Just be online. Okay, totally 51 students have attended today's lecture. This recording and the PowerPoint, I will put in the GCR. You can check that. Okay. Any doubt? No doubt. किसी को डाउट नहीं है?
नो सर।
ओके बेटा, थैंक यू।